We're given y equals sine 3x, and if delta x equals 0.2 at x equals 0, we want to use a linear approximation to estimate delta y, where delta y represents the change of y of the given function. And for our linear approximation, we'll use a tangent line at x equals 0. The change of y along the tangent line would be differential y given here. So delta y is approximately equal to differential y, which is equal to f prime of x times dx, with the given function would be f of x. Before we make our linear approximation though, let's look at a graph. The given function is graphed here in blue. The tangent line at x equals 0 is graphed here in red. So notice, as x increases from 0 to 0.2, we're using the change of y of the tangent line to approximate the change of y of the function, where the distance from the x-axis to this point here on the red tangent line would be differential y, and the distance from the x-axis to the point on the function here would actually be delta y. So we're using differential y to approximate delta y. Let's go ahead and find f prime of x. The derivative of sine 3x would be equal to cosine 3x times 3, or 3 times cosine 3x. Also notice x is equal to 0, and delta x, which equals differential x, or dx, is 0.2. So we have differential y is equal to f prime of 0, which would be 3 times cosine 3 times 0, which is 0, times differential x, which is 0.2. So we have 3 times cosine 0 is 1, times 0.2. So our approximation for delta y, or differential y, is going to be equal to 0.6, or 6/10. And now we're asked to find the error percentage, which is going to be equal to differential y minus delta y divided by delta y times 100, where this would be our estimate minus the true change of y divided by the true change of y. And delta y is equal to f of the quantity x plus delta x minus f of x. Let's first find delta y, again where x equals 0 and delta x equals 0.2. So we'd have f of 0 plus 0.2, or just 0.2, minus f of 0. Again, this would be the true change of y from x equals 0 to 0.2. Well, f of 0.2 would just be sine of 3 times 0.2, that's going to be 0.6, minus f of 0, which would be sine 0. But since sine 0 is 0, delta y is just sine 0.6. Which means the error percentage would be differential y, our estimate, minus delta y, which is sine 0.6, divided by sine 0.6. To convert to a percentage, we multiply by 100. And now we'll go to the calculator. We'll put the numerator in parentheses, so we'll have an open parenthesis, 0.6 minus sine 0.6, close parenthesis for sine, close parenthesis for the numerator, and then divided by sine 0.6. To convert to a percentage, we can move the decimal point to the right two places or multiply by 100. So as a percentage, if we rounded two decimal places, this would be approximately 6.26% error. I hope you found this helpful.